bubbles.
Byron, bubbles are a fascinating scientific phenomenon. Mm.
Bubbles. She is one of the finest women I ever met.
I lose what the premise of science is. Before you go to the moon, you have a premise. And that premise is the constancy of natural law.
Scientist?
Now, the premise in religion is the existence of a God.
Philosopher?
Well, I'm thinking very profoundly now. And then it came to me like a flash.
Psychic.
Bubbles will last if they do not break.
Bubbles will last forever. Now, that may not sound too profound to some people, but to this man, it is the foundation of a very special 50-year love affair.
Funny, isn't it? But it's true. Bubbles will last if they don't break.
A love affair with soap bubbles. Eighty-year-old Eiffel Plaster is the Beethoven of bubbles, the grand master of those slippery globules. Nearly 50 years ago, Eiffel began experimenting with these sudsy wonders and ended up creating the only bubble show in the world. He calls it his Bubbles Concerto.
I've been blowing bubbles for 50 years. Well, but I must say, I was working with bubbles all prior to that time.
As a young physics teacher, Eiffel used bubbles for science class demonstrations. His interest in bubbles became so keen and his mastery of them so great, he soon started performing with bubbles professionally. To Eiffel, the wondrous bubble wasn't something you just blew. Bubbles should be touched and tickled, caressed and coddled.
It's fun. You lift your bubble up like that and squeeze your fingers like that, drop it, reach out and catch it, and hold it in your hand. You can just play with it and cat with it.
After playing around with his bubbles, Eiffel finally gets down to business and begins sculpting them. Here he is creating one of his famous vertical chains, which when completed, becomes his 5-foot Eiffel bubble tower.
I want to be the master of the show. See, I want to tell these bubbles what to do, and I want them to do it. I tell them to join, I want them to join. See, I want to be the master. But that isn't the way it is. That's the way it may appear. That's the way I'd like for it to appear for a little bit. But really, I'm kind of humbled. The bubbles are the masters, and I've got to do it their way.
Indeed, Plaster does it their way, but watch as he commands these two bubbles to mate.
We're two bubbles, and join together and become one, to the count of 10. 1, 2, 3, come on, 4, come on, 5, 6, come on and join. Thank you.
When Eiffel isn't busy with his bubbles, like many artists, scientists, and philosophers, he retreats to his farm, where he's revitalized by nature.
The wonders of this world, and some people go through life without being enthused about the beauty and the wonder of the world. We're living in a marvelous world, it's amazing, and it's beyond our comprehension.
Much of Eiffel's wonderful world is made up of the bubble, which he feels almost has a life of its own. At one time, he produced a bubble that survived in a jar for 340 days, the longest ever recorded. But he discovered if bubbles are born, they also die.
Last year, I saw something new that I'd never seen before. I saw two of them die the natural death. I call that the twilight period of a bubble, where it finally disappears, gets smaller and smaller and smaller until it finally fades away. So the bubble in twilight is the bubble beyond visible sight.
To Eiffel, the bubble is in fact a microcosm of the universe. He says there's nothing more frail in all the world than the solution of soap that, when formed by breathing air into it, parallels creation itself. By finding so much magic and so much joy in an ordinary soap bubble, 80-year-old Eiffel Plaster has found even more joy in his extraordinary world.
Turn off the bubble machine. The wonderful bubble machine.
Legend in these parts. In case you don't know Eiffel, he's 87 years old. He's been a teacher and farmer in Huntington County. And for the past 55 years, he's been blowing soap bubbles for audiences of all ages. We caught up with Eiffel over the weekend, and tonight on Ken Owens, Indiana, a profile of the man they call Professor Bubbles. Eiffel Plasterer says he always thought bubbles were for kids until he was a student at DePaul University in Greencastle. A science professor there used a soap bubble to demonstrate the vibrations of sound. Still, Eiffel didn't start blowing bubbles himself until he graduated from college in 1924.
And that fall, I had a teaching job, and that's when I asked this class, I said, any of you folks know how to make a bubble solution? I want you to tell me, because I know a lot of tricks in soap bubbles, and I think you would enjoy them.
In 1932, Eiffel performed publicly for the first time, and he's still going strong. He and his daughter Alice do about 20 shows a year for schools, churches, and civic groups. The shows are called Bubble Concertos. Eiffel does a lot of research. He's continually changing his soap formula to improve on the size and durability of his bubbles.
Bubbles will last if they do not break. That's a profound statement. And that guides you to making the search for something that doesn't break too soon. See, why do soap bubbles have to break? And I worked on that idea, and I commenced to get results.
Eiffel's fame extends beyond our area. He's appeared around the country and on network TV shows like Real People and Late Night with David Letterman. Eiffel says he loves entertaining an audience and especially likes the reaction his shows get from youngsters.
I find that they are so nice. You see, I tell them, I say, how many ever blew soap bubbles? Well, all the hands go. I says, good. Now I feel better. I know I'm...
for me, then I realized once I attained that, that I then must move on. And if I lost it all tomorrow, as long as I was healthy and my family was together, it wouldn't bother me a great deal, because I believe any man who does it once can do it twice.
Okay. Wayne Newton, thanks so much for letting us share your home in Las Vegas. Best to Mrs. Newton and the family. And break a leg tonight, okay?
Thank you. Come
all
back
right.
Sometime.
Okay. Good night, Wayne. We will continue from New York and meet Mr. Bubbles and tell you about the rest of the week right after these announcements from the NBC television stations.
I forever blow wing bubbles. Pretty bubbles in the air.
We have had more fun here today with Eiffel Plasterer, who is Mr. Bubbles, who's with us tonight from Indiana, and who, as I say, discovered some years ago that bubbles were extremely fascinating, and he's here tonight to give a little demonstration of a show which he's traveled around the country as an educational and entertainment experience. Mr. Plasterer, Eiffel, Mr. Bubbles, good evening. It's a little
good evening.
Tough to talk with those hoses in your mouth. What do you got going here?
Yeah.
Whoops. Oh, there we are.
Yeah.
Where did you get the... briefly here, when did you start fooling around with bubbles?
When I was 25 years old in 1925.
Mm-hmm. And what was the reason that you started fooling around with bubbles?
Oh, I had a good, legitimate reason for a man to blow soap bubbles. I was teaching physics, and I knew from my professor of physics that bubbles could be used very nicely to demonstrate many physical laws and truths. And so I had made up my mind that I would learn to blow bubbles. But here I had a class before me. I was several months teaching physics, and so I said one evening, or right after the class, I said, now, if any of you folks know how to blow soap bubbles, let me know, because there's lots of tricks that we can do that you'll enjoy. Well, they started to tell me how they blew bubbles. And so I humbled myself before my students, and they told me, and I immediately went to my old chemistry teacher, who was now in the city, and I thought he knew a lot about bubbles, maybe. And so I asked him if he had any idea how to blow bubbles. He did not know, but he said he knew where to find. And so he looked up a big book, And there it told me how to blow bubbles. But the tricks weren't near as good as the professor's, and so I started out with the search, a quest for bubbles that would last long enough to do a trick with.
There you go. So now you've got a special solution or something, right?
That's
you know,
right.
Just this isn't ivory soap and water in here.
Oh, no, that's right.
Is this available commercially, your stuff?
No, that's not commercial. I did supply some educational houses, I mean, for it.
Well, you know, they had this thing when I was a kid, the first ones that came out where you dipped the wire into the solution and did that, and bubbles came out.
Well,
you sell this stuff with that, and you make yourself $1 million, for heaven's sake.
Well, that's what started the show off. For 10 years, I was working just purely for the making scientific tricks. But one day, I found out that if I happened to have a ring, that I could blow a bubble with the ring, see, and like this, see.
Okay.
Of course, these are larger rings than that, but I found out later on that to
gotta get the film across there, huh?
And so here it comes. And you see, it could...
All right!
So that's possible to use the ring bubble. Well, I told a friend...
Can I try that?
Oh, yeah, sure, sure.
Is there a little secret to it?
Let's just kind of pull this back. Sure, you got it. That's interesting. Let's see.
Mine just kind of lays there. Well, never getting anybody else's act.
Well, that's all right. That's all right. Here.
Don't try to sing the guy's song, right?
I tried to get bubbles that would last, and so, of course, I have different solutions, and in this solution, I have bubbles that last for days.
What is the longest-lasting bubble you've ever blown?
Well, the longest-lasting bubble that I've ever blown lasted 340 days.
In a bottle?
That's right. Under glass, to protect it against the dust and wind.
That's amazing.
Well, it is amazing, but I'm not the only one that makes long-life bubbles. This Dr. Gross of Philadelphia is quite interested in that and in plastic bubbles, and I've had the pleasure of...
Can I see another one of those that you make, the big ones?
Huh?
I want to see another one of those big ones.
You'd like to see more?
Yeah, one more big one.
Well, here, say, let me try this little trick here. Here's a little trick here. Oh, well, I'm going to try this little trick for you.
Okay. The bubble inside the bubble. Oh, isn't that fun? Whoops. No.
By the way, let me try this trick.
Okay.
This is a... Magicians always like to make things disappear. Well, that's one thing I am good at. I can make bubbles disappear, see?
I've made whole shows disappear.
Yes, right here, like this. Now, here, you see, I have two rings, but for all practical purpose, there's just one bubble there, see?
All right.
Now, thrust your arm through that.
Right through here?
Yeah, and break it. So, here, broke it. Well, let's try it again. I fumbled it. I had one ring on.
I think you had it.
Yeah, okay. Here it goes. Here. And we'll get this again. Now, we'll try it again.
All right.
So thrust your arm through there.
Just right through it.
Yeah.
Break it.
Right, break it.
Let's bust it. Wrong.
See, and we have two instead of none. Okay. Here is a pipe that's been electrically heated, and we are going to attempt to blow a bubble with it.
I think the big ring is probably a little more successful.
If I'm trying to blow a hot air bubble, and if I get that, it's...
It'll float, right? You know what's happening, Professor?
No.
We're in a cool room with warm solution, and I think the two are at odds. But then again, look at.
Oh, you have to work for these
look
things.
Look at that thing go.
And now we have a hot air bubble. I appreciate that, especially in this case.
Oh, that's fantastic.
I would like for you to always remember that there's lifter in hot air, and remember it the next time you hear it. By the way, this is a great day in my life, because one of the greatest days, and I should say the highest day I ever had. And I'm thinking of at the time that America was being born, a nation, over in France, the air age was being born, when the Montgolfier brothers put up the first hot air balloon.
Mm-hmm.
And today, that quest in the air age put me here to New York from a very high area, when man first put up by means of hot air balloon.
Right. What is this one here?
Oh, this is to show the square bubble. Now, I'd like for Alice to help me on this trick.
Okay, you Alice, see, why don't you come in?
Many people ask if I can blow a square bubble. Well, actually, I cannot blow a square bubble, but I can produce it with a square frame. Notice I placed the frame in solution, and the square bubble comes out. But there's other tricks besides that. Notice that it's flat,
mm-hmm.
because the rubber-like behavior gives it the shape of the minimal shape, and
the
hence
square,
the
right.
sphere.
Right.
But over here, the minimal shape is just a plane. Now, the interesting thing is, when we put this in solution and have three square bubbles, we can break them apart like this one and there, and we can have what we'd call curvature without pressure. Notice we're going
curvature
to break this.
Curvature without pressure, ladies
That's
and
right.
gentlemen. All right. Little
you
respect
see,
for curvature
in,
without pressure.
Over yonder.
Yep, I see it breaking away there.
There.
There she
you
goes.
You see, there we have curvature with pressure in
right.
that bubble. But over here, we have the pressure the same on both sides, see?
Right.
And there we have the catenary curve, the curve of the bridge arch.
Exactly.
Or drooping drapes.
Drooping drapes.
Alice is producing the curvature with a tetrahedron.
Does it bother you that your father blows bubbles all the time?
No.
Oh, okay. What was the thing you had going here with
well,
these?
Well, I want to show one more thing here because we're coming to the best.
Well, we're coming to the end, too,
Oh, I like a play. We're going to hear. You must see this because
right.
you like this.
Let me take a
see
shot
here.
At it.
Look here. Now we have a little tiny square bubble in the center, see?
Exactly.
See?
Okay,
in the center. See?
Gotcha.
Right there in the center.
Right there in the center.
Yeah, okay. Now we'll trap some air into this formation. And we will lift out a beautiful geometric compromise between the sphere and the square. Alice will do the same thing and have a beautiful compromise between the tetrahedron and
the oxymora.
The sphere.
Now, let me do a little commercial here,
okay.
and then I promise that you try to blow a bubble around me. Would you?
Okay.
Okay, we'll be right back for that historic event after these announcements. Don't leave. Well, tell me what to do.
Lean forward.
Okay. Got it. Here we go. Showtime. Bubble over Snyder. Here it goes. 6 feet four, a bubble. And showtime. Thank you, sir. Good night, everybody.
Of the release soon. A network like ABC spends a lot of time and money bringing you stories like those in the Persian Gulf. It also seeks out people in this country who, for one reason or another, stand out among the rest of us. Good Morning America recently came to Huntington to do a story on one such person. 21 Alive's Elizabeth Knopf was there too to find out why the network found Eiffel Plasterer so special.
As the Good Morning America crew's camera rolled, Eiffel Plasterer becomes lost in his world of making bubbles. On hand for the show, preschoolers from Trinity Methodist Church. Eiffel, with the help of his daughter, Alice Jacob, entertain once or twice a month and have done so all over the country. He says that bubbles educate. For instance, he showed the children that forming a bubble with hydrogen causes it to rise. Add a little oxygen and... Eiffel's been pleasing crowds and himself with the bubbles ever since he saw his physics professor at DePaul University do much the same thing. Eiffel went on to teach physics and chemistry, but retired early to devote more of his time to bubbles, which he says continues to intrigue him.
The wonderful thing is happening that I am discovering new ways of bubbles. Seems that when it comes to bubbles, I'm wondering why I didn't discover this years before.
His story on Good Morning America is due to air December 18th. That morning, 5 million people will be watching him. How does he feel about that?
The only regret is that it didn't come sooner, when I had more strength than back 40 years ago, see.
Good Morning America heard about Eiffel 6 years ago, but because of scheduling conflicts, both theirs and his, they could only just now shoot the story. GMA correspondent Hattie Kaufman is the reporter covering the story.
My opinion is just awe, because he's having so much fun doing what he does. He enjoys his life, and this has been his life since he first blew a bubble when he was 25 years old, and now he's 88 years old. What a way to spend your life. Playing.
Kaufman says GMA traveled to Huntington to do this story because it's a positive way for their viewers to start the day. Because both his bubbles and Eiffel himself are uplifting.
It's a fun to be alive. It's a great privilege to be alive.
On Monday, ladies and gentlemen, Bob and Ray will be here, also Sybil Shepherd. My next guest, this man is an Indiana resident who has been demonstrating the wonders of bubbles for the last 50 years. Please welcome Bubble Master Eiffel Plasterer. Eiffel, nice to see you. Thank you very much for being here. Where in Indiana do you live?
Huntington.
You know, I'm from Indianapolis. Did you know that?
Huh?
I'm from Indianapolis.
Oh, well, I'm glad to know that, yes.
Yeah, and I went to school in Muncie. Is Muncie near Huntington?
I heard about that.
Oh, okay. Eiffel, let's go ahead now. You started there with a very impressive bubble. Why don't you go ahead and show us whatever you want to show us tonight, and if
Thank
I can
you.
Help you, let me know. And I know your daughter is here. Alice is here?
I will have you.
Okay, we'll introduce Alice in a minute, all right?
Okay, yes,
okay.
By all means.
But let's go ahead and start with the bubbles.
Start with it.
Yeah, all righty. Is that special bubble solution? Probably not a good time to be answering questions, is it? Wow, that's very impressive. Did you design this equipment, Eiffel? Okay. All right. Now you've joined two bubbles together there, haven't you? Will you be able to talk to me for the rest of the night? Pretty much out here on my own then, aren't I? Well, four bubbles. And five? What's the most bubbles you've joined together? How many has he done, Alice?
About 12.
About 12. Does he, how many do you think he'll do tonight?
No.
What is that stuff he's using?
That's a glycerin solution.
Glycerin solution? All right. Have his own formula?
Own formula.
Mm-hmm. And you're going to attempt now to more bubbles in a row here.
Probably about seven.
About seven, okay. Five there, but 12 is the record. One, two, three, four, five, six. Try one more. Yeah, there's. I think the air conditioning might be a problem. That's very impressive. Oh my goodness. That was your chain of bubbles, wasn't it? All right, what are you going to do for us now, Eiffel?
Defy the laws of mathematics.
All right, and what does that mean exactly?
Well, we know that 1 + 1 = 2.
That's correct.
That's right, except in cases when it doesn't mean that. Here is... I am about to try to join together two bubbles. This time I have one bubble plus one bubble will make one bubble.
Whoa.
One join to the count of 10, join. 1, 2, 3. Thank you.
No, I don't like it. It's some kind of witchcraft or something. I tell you, he can't be trusted. Now what, Eiffel? By the way, just to introduce your daughter, Alice.
Oh, yes, by all means.
No. What is your daughter's name?
Alice Jacobs.
Alice Jacobs. Yes. Alice, nice to see you. Thank you for helping out tonight. All right, and now what?
I'm going to try to defy the law of gravity.
Uh-huh. And once again, this means there's no point in me talking to you. How long is it? 50 years he's been bubbling, yeah. Right? Okay. Now, so far, it's pretty much adhering to the laws
up,
of gravity.
Up! Come on.
Come on. Come on. Whoa! That's very impressive. Now, how did you do that? How did you get the bubble to move upward?
Well, that's a magic show.
Oh.
Yeah. Well.
So you're not going to tell us?
No.
This is very impressive. Your own secret formula.
We're running into the end of my number. Do you want some others in?
Well, whatever you want, Eiffel. I'm sure.
Can we pour that all in?
Okay. We have about 1 minute.
Oh, yes. Why?
So we want to see everything you have.
So how easy a bubble can how you can. Many bubbles we can get here.
Okay.
See?
All right. Thank you very much. Oh, all right. Okay. Alice has handed me the... Oh, excuse me. I'm sorry. Now, wait a minute. Okay, there we go. Oh! Let me try this one more time. A little more slowly. Wait a minute. I can get one out of there. I know just how disappointed. All right, now do we have? Okay. I didn't quite get it. Eiffel, why don't we do this last very exciting trick? Now, if I'd have done that properly, we'd had a huge bubble floating around, wouldn't we?
Well, you did it fine.
Oh, thank you. Okay. What do you want me to do?
Stand in here. And make yourself as little as possible.
All righty.
Bringing your arms in close.
No.
No.
No? Leave
That's
it on?
Right. Yeah, it's okay.
Now. What about my wallet? Do you need my wallet?
Here.
Keep my hands at my side.
Now, we will...
It's going to actually encase me in a bubble, isn't it? Pull a bubble up around me. There will be no oxygen in there. Here we go.
You have to.
All right. Pulling the bubble up.